The history of the parental advisory label. The year is 1985, and Tipper Gore, the wife of then Senator Al Gore, who later on became vice president to Bill Clinton, buys Prince's album Purple Rain for her teenage daughter and stumbles upon a song called Darling Nikki, which references a woman practicing masturbation. Infuriated by the vulgarity in the song, she creates the PMRC, the Parents Music Resource Center, with three other wives whose husbands are in politics as well. She launches a campaign to ban albums with such content and brings it to Senate in the same year. They presented a list called the Filthy 15, which included Madonna, Prince, AC/DC, Def Leppard, and Cyndi Lauper. They get their wish. The RIAA, Recording Industry Association of America, gives in and complies. Britain's BPI, the British Phonographic Industry, will follow suit in the 1990s. A legal requirement to paste a parental advisory sticker is set in stone, and naturally, the artists push back. At a hearing between the PMRC and artists, Frank Zappa calls the move censorship and a waste of government funds and would never have passed had the woman not been married to such powerful men. N.W.A. Straight Out of Compton's album was one of the first rap albums to get the label in 1988. There was concern amongst the industry insiders that this would bring down the record sales, and especially when Walmart decides to not shelve any stickered albums, this made many others decide to make a clean version of their albums. An example is 1990's Two Live Crew album, As Nasty As They Wanna Be. They created a clean, censored version, As Clean As They Wanna Be, hiding all previously exposed nudity on the cover. The deterrent failed and backfired as kids rebelled and the sticker became a symbol for anti-establishment. Record companies began slapping these labels on albums just to drive sales as a marketing tool. Rap albums would get pressured into being labeled more than rock and roll albums would, even though the lyrics were just as grittier. N.W.A. even had a song, Parental Discretion Is Advised, playing on the whole scenario. In 1994, the sticker was revised and became what we have today, forever cementing itself in music history. Now that, people, is the history of the Parental Advisory sticker, which later on became a label. And don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe.